Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It's Francesco here and I hope you guys are all well. Today we're going to be diving into Superhuman, which is an email application with some high spec abilities. Now I'm going to be diving into my own experience of the last 3 months of using it and talking about some of the core elements of this application. Today's video is actually sponsored by Superhuman, so big thank you to the team. You can check the link out in the description below and explore more about how this application works in this video. So I want to start with what is Superhuman. I've done a couple of videos on this before, also chatting with the founding team if you wanted to check it out a couple of years ago, and that will be in the link in the description. But Superhuman basically tried to rebuild email from the ground up with intelligent features that helps you read, triage, and organize your email better. Now in particular, something I wasn't doing compared to other email applications was actually keyboard focused sort of management. And that's something that's very heavily pushed in Superhuman and actually a lot easier to learn than I thought. Never a keyboard guy, but now very much am. And it does help me to process my inbox a lot faster. So let's touch on those core elements and then I wanna move on to my own experience from using it so far. So the first feature that I wanna zoom in on is the split inbox. This is really a neat feature for triaging email. It's sort of like automatic triage, but essentially you can manage your email into these like tabs and you can actually use a tab button to move across them rapidly, but you can organize them into a bit more sort of customized experiences. For example, like VIP can be for your most important emails. You could create one for your team with any team members that email you, but you can basically split this up using Command K, which helps you to narrow down who you want in each stream of email. Now I found this particularly helpful. For example, I've done one on affiliate sales to be able to see like a feed of affiliate sales that are coming in. I've done this for Bento with VIP, having people signed up to it that are particularly effective when it comes to projects that we need to move forward. And I can go quickly to VIP and see those emails without having to triage my whole inbox every single time. So split inbox is a great function and definitely something I recommend. The second feature is remind me. Now this is obviously a way to snooze your emails. So you can simply snooze an email for another time and you can even pick it up on your desktop as well. If it's something that, for example, you require a large file or something to be sent over, you can actually remind you when you're back on your desktop, which is pretty cool. But there's actually a feature, for example, when you're sending an email, you can actually get it to remind you when to follow up with the other person, which is something that I do quite often when sending emails because I don't want to lose maybe a communication, and it helps you to do that without having to add it to your to-do list every single time, which is really painful in my opinion. The third feature to zoom in on is the calendar function, and they've really worked on this over the last couple of months, actually releasing a feature before, but I didn't know that they actually had this until sort of playing around with it. And it's really cool because you can organize meetings without the need to necessarily go to your email application. And you can add things like Zoom, Google Meet conferencing all within there, just using the keyboard. And actually there's a lot of things, small things that intuitively do stuff in the background. And you can also invite other people quite easily too. So I found the email function, the email to calendar function actually better than I thought. I didn't know it was going to be as good as I was thinking. Next up is snippets. Now, snippets are a way to replicate processes, almost like templates in your email. They could be quickly brought up and even, for example, brought in with CC or BCC and even include custom variables like attachments as well. So snippets I found particularly helpful because I give you a good example of how it can work. Is we had like this issue on our courses site where we can't sell to a certain country. Well, I was having to send this email every single time. And naturally, obviously I wanted to save a bit of time doing that. So I set up a snippet for it and it definitely saves me the hundredth time of retyping it and actually being able to do that. So I can use snippets on mobile as well, so I can quickly send them on the go too. Next up, send later. This is also a really good function if you want to get into people's inbox at the right time zone. So you can actually choose the right time zone to get and schedule the email to land in that person's inbox. And this is really good, especially if you've got releases or critical emails And you can also set a useful follow-up too, so you can make sure to still keep in contact if you're sending later as well. So in terms of my own experience from using this, first off, I did the 45-minute call. And to be honest, I wasn't expecting what I was going to expect, if you know what I mean. I had the 45-minute call and actually learned a lot more about how I can triage my inbox better. So it was almost like a productivity lesson, but also a way to set up on this. And one thing that they quite sort of, I guess, a focus quite intentionally on is the command bar. And the command K function and being able to use a command bar has literally become second nature to me. And being able to manage it is email using the command bar, sort of quickly making prompts and using the keyboard, has actually saved a lot of time. I honestly didn't think I was going to use a command or even keyboard as much as I do, but I rarely use the mouse pad when managing email now. It's really done all on the keyboard, which is really great because it's really easily managed. The second thing that I want to pay attention to is the tabbing. I really like quickly tabbing across different things. And I found on mobile, it's really awesome and easy to actually tab across stuff because you can swipe across and switch accounts quite easily. And it was quite really rapid at the bottom, which I found quite easy. The other thing as well is a pop-up email as well. This is something that when you scroll to midway through an email, it says, do you want to pop up the reply in your email? And there's just subtle things that come up at the bottom that once you learn the keyboard shortcut, it make your life a lot easier. And popping up email is actually something when you're trying to write an email back can save you a lot of time. So actually the command bar is a really underrated feature inside of Superhuman. So that was a little bit of an overview of Superhuman. To give you an idea of those key features, you can naturally go through them again using the timestamps. And that's a little bit of my experience. I say that compared to my previous experience with Tempo, it's probably like doubled my speed of email. It did take a few, probably about a week to get used to everything. Not only that, but the keyboard shortcuts and naturally the user interface and things like that. But to be honest, it's really nice because previously I had like an app for a desktop and an app for phone. There were two separate applications for managing email and it was horrible, but actually having a robust email on my phone has actually helped and allowed me to respond, because I was previously a bit scared, like, oh, I can't respond because it hasn't got the same functionality as I need it to. But it's actually really, really easy. And one thing I like as well is on the phone, it comes up in this lovely conversation view too, which is just a nice and small thing that they've added. So folks, a big, big thank you. A huge thanks to Superhuman for sponsoring today's video. Hopefully this gave everyone who's interested in it a sort of overview of how I'm using it. You can check out the link in the description. If you have any more questions about my own Superhuman use, you can feel free to ask them below. But a big thank you, folks, and I'll talk to you all very, very soon. Cheerio.